North Dakota State opened conference play with a victory over Illinois State on homecoming a week ago, showing they are poised for another strong run at a Valley title. Today, the Bison are on the road, meeting the upstart Missouri State Bears. It's next on the KVLY KFYR Bison Network.
Get your horns out! Cause it's Bison time.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Plaster Field here in Springfield, Missouri for Missouri Valley Conference football here on the KVLY KFYR Bison Network. Brian, Sean, Lee Timmerman with you for two programs that are off to very good starts this season. And for North Dakota State, 4-0, 1-0 in the Valley, number one in the country. And offensively, LT, they have received contributions from a number of different guys in both the pass and run game.
I think one of the most interesting stats leading into this game through the first part of the year for NDSU is that the Bison have been in the red zone only eight times. Six of those were touchdowns, so there's 11 other touchdowns that are coming from beyond the 20-yard line. I told that stat to Randy Hedberg, and he goes, geez, wow, oh, really? Yeah, but I think we saw it last week, you know, when Stick hit nine different receivers, had the big plays down the field. The Bison have turned into a fairly big play offense.
And Missouri State, a team that is playing with confidence. They snapped their 0-for-13 Missouri Valley Conference losing streak, winning on the road at Indiana State, and the largest margin of victory they've had on the road in their program's history.
And I think one of the things from talking with the Bison coaches this week, every single one of them, coaches from NDSU side, were so appreciative of the way that Coach Steckel stayed with his program. I mean, we know the Bears were not good last year. It didn't matter. They stayed the course. They're a year older, mentally into the playbook, and, you know, matured physically. They're ready to go, and so far the 3-1 start, I think, is, you know, a part of what they did last year. Even though they got beat, they stayed the course.
What are you looking for early here, LT, when you look at these two programs squaring off?
Well, I think the Bison want to try to establish some physical dominance in this thing, so that's on both sides of the ball. One of the things I heard Coach Steckel say, why is NDSU good? Well, they have a good offensive line. They have a good defensive line. That's why their program has been what it is.
Well, Beth Houle is on the sidelines for us today and has an update on North Dakota State. Beth?
Hey guys, a lot of adjustments for the offense this week. I talked to offensive coordinator Tim Polasek, who said they spent a good hour and a half on Friday night readjusting their play card as they make accommodations for the fact that Chase Morlock is not in attendance at this game, and they're adjusting for injuries. The fullback position is basically empty this week, and head coach Chris Kleiman telling me that it's actually going to be tight ends stepping in to that fullback position to try and make some more plays, give the team some more options, as they've really enjoyed flexing that fullback muscle this season, and it's made a difference in the play calls they've been able to attack teams with. Ultimately, it's going to come down to the running backs and the offensive line being able to move that line forward as the Bison continue to try and force their will upon their opponents. That's, of course, coming down to the defense, who I know has taken a few comments from the Missouri State football team personally this week. Missouri State Bears trying to make a little of the physicality that the Bison football team brings to the field. Well, the defense is ready to show them exactly how physical Bison football can be.
Beth, thanks so much. Bison won the toss. They deferred, so Cam Peterson will kick off. Deion Holloman is deep for Missouri State as we get set to kick things off here this afternoon on a beautiful sunny day here in Springfield.
One of the most dangerous return men in all of FCS. He had a 91-yarder earlier this year, and last year led everyone in kick return yardage.
Here's a Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Jumbled and taken there by Holloman, who's got a seam. And a good start here for Missouri State on special teams. Short kickoff taken by Holloman after it was dropped up to the 37. Here is the starting lineups for the North Dakota State defense, brought to you by Shields.
Brett Ambrosius, DePere, Wisconsin. Nate Tangway, McGuanago, Wisconsin.
Aaron Seidel, Carlos, Minnesota. Luke Menard, Lakeville, Minnesota.
MJ Stumpf, Harvey, North Dakota.
Matt Plank, Gardner, Kansas.
PRG Tucker, Belleville, Illinois.
Jalen Winbush, St. Petersburg, Florida.
Robbie Grimsley, Hutchinson, Minnesota.
Trey Dempsey, Lakeland, Florida.
Dylan Allison, Papillion, Nebraska.
Nice job defensively by North Dakota State. First carry of the day for Jason Randall, and he loses a yard back to the 36. Nice job by Matt Plank, among others.
Matt Plank on a little zone read. That's the main running thing that Missouri State will do today. It's their base type of a play. Run option with the quarterback. Sometimes he'll pull back and throw on that. Plank read run, did a perfect job in his fit.
Missouri State going quick tempo here as Brody Lambert swings it out, caught by Randall, turns it upfield, and a nice gain near a first down that time by Randall. He's about 2 yards short to the 45. Here's a look at your Shield starting lineup for that MSU offense. Lambert in, the quarterback, coming off a career game at Indiana State. The offensive line a year older, and certainly keep an eye out for Holloman, as LT mentioned. Malik R. Earl also had a huge game last week against the Sycamores. Direct snap and a first down on the Wildcat formation to Randall, and the Bears pick it up to the 49.
The Bears used the Wildcat in the first quarter last week as well, so it's part of their, you know, it's something NDSU knew was coming in a short yardage situation. Go ahead and avoid the handoff. Go directly to one of your top tailbacks, something that the Bears have done multiple times this year and last week again early.
24 first half points for Missouri State last week. Handoff outside, and the Bison all over that one. Plank again along with Tuska for a loss of two back to the 47.
Tremendous job on the read here from the defense from NDSU. Both guards pulled out in front. The Bison got in front of that, took out the blockers, the two guards. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. See the guards coming in? Yeah, that was PRG Tucker giving himself up, knowing he's not going to make the tackle, but doing what he needed to do, allow Bates to make the tackle.
Lambert, quick throw in the flat, caught again, picking his way all the way inside NDSU territory down to the 44-yard line is Holloman, his first reception of the day, and the Bears, a manageable third down conversion coming up.
Well, one of the things you want to do is get that kid in space. Give him the opportunity to make a move. Holloman really puts pressure on the tacklers. I tell you, if he makes the first guy miss, the second guy better get him, because otherwise he might be gone.
Holloman in motion, gets the carry, steps out of one tackle, and eventually pushed out of bounds. Oh, he has a first down up to the 36-yard line.
Last week against Indiana State, the Bears went pass early and often. In fact, Earl caught the first six plays of the game. Now we obviously know what the Bears want to do here. That again, go to Holloman, another one of their big playmakers. We've seen him have a kick return. Now he's run it a couple of times, putting pressure on the edge against the Bison.
Matt Entz, defensive coordinator for North Dakota State, said he expected to see this set from Missouri State early just because of what Eastern Washington and the success they've had. He goes, we're going to see it until we show we can handle it. Lambert drops, quick in the flat, caught. That's Furmanek, the tight end. Gain of about five inside the 35 to the 33.
Furmanek was the guy who was the motion man. He came in motion and then kind of got lost in the shuffle, just off to the flat. Now, Lambert at times will appear that out of the shotgun will take maybe like a three-step drop, so it's more sometimes of a 10-yard drop, but they want to get the ball out of his hands quickly today against NDSU, because we know what the Bison can do when the quarterback has to throw.
Lambert flushed out, rolling right, and he's going to throw this one away. Nice job defensively by North Dakota State. Ambrosius was putting on the pressure.
The number one way to disrupt an offense is from defensive line pressure. And that's what the Bison did on that particular play. It was a simple four-man rush. I mean, there were nobody else coming, no blitzes, but at least two of the Bison guys beat their man, and then the third one got into the play, and that play was disrupted there. Lambert did what a fifth-year senior quarterback should do, and that's just not eat it, throw it away, live to play another play.
Lambert will take the snap and roll. Fires across the middle and into coverage, and it is caught. Nice job adjusting to the football there by Aaron Denson, the freshman out of Fort Worth, Texas. Another third down conversion for Missouri State. Trey Dempsey on the coverage.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. You're rolling Lambert to give him time to wait for this to open up. It's the shorter of the two pass patterns. Grimsley is coming into the play late. He has to because there's a fly pattern down the right sideline. He has to honor that. You know you have a one-on-one in the short flat, that 15, 10, that's about a 12-yard out. 12-yard out, good read, good throw.
And again, this is what Missouri State did last week against Indiana State. They got in rhythm right away and scored 45 points en route to a 21-point victory in Terre Haute.
Yeah, that game was tied at halftime, and then the Bears scored all 21 points in the second half.
Lambert has time again, fires across the middle, through the hands of his intended target, Malik Earl, incomplete.
Hey, here's a situation, Brian, where I was talking about to where the quarterback will take that three-step drop out of the shotgun, so it's almost like a seven-step drop timing on the pass patterns. You allow your receivers more time to get open. Earl was the wide guy, and he ran a really kind of a deep cut across the middle. He was way to the field side when that play started, but his quarterback with the deep drop allows you to run patterns that take that long to develop.
Hand off to the outside to Randall. Bison stringing it out, and Randall is not going to get back to the line of scrimmage. Good team pursuit by the Bison, and a loss of three.
Jalen Winbush is the guy who gives himself up. He just tries to pressure the edge and force that play to belly out a little bit deeper. So Winbush, again, real nice job of being physical from his corner spot. Bison corners have to tackle.
So the Bears now backed up. Third and 13 from the 26.
It's taken a while in this drive, but the Bison do have the Bears in the position they want.
Lambert has time again, and now he runs out of time. Taken down on the backside by Greg Menard.
What was it Coach Steckel said about Menard earlier this week?
He called him a man-eater and a beast of all the beasts.
One-on-one on the outside. If you're going to do that against Greg Menard, we're going to see more Nodak Mutual Insurance replays of him getting sacks. If you're the Bears, you simply cannot do that. If you've got Menard one-on-one, the Bison are licking their chops.
This would be, by far, a season long. The longest field goal that has been made by Missouri State this year is 24 yards. And the kicker, Zach Drake, is 0 of 2 from 30-plus. This is from 50.
Yeah, Drake came into the program as a wide receiver.
Toe to it. Boy, it looks pretty good if it gets there. And it is good from 50 yards for Drake, the redshirt freshman out of Lee's Summit, Missouri.
Yeah, he became the punter by default because the Missouri State punter got injured. And like I said, came in as a wide receiver and just nails a 50-yarder after being 2 of 4. Both his misses were in the Murray State game, and they were bad misses too. One of them was pushed way to the right, and the other one was almost shanked. So talk about confidence if you're the kicker. How about a 50-yarder?
And fortunately for the kickers today, LT, no conditions to deal with. It is 75. There is no wind. It is a beautiful day here in Missouri today.
If you could take these conditions, put them in your back pocket, and take them with you wherever you go, no matter what time of the year it is, you'd be in heaven because it is a gorgeous day here today. So that's one of those good news, bad news type of a situation drives. Good news, you know, for Missouri State, they scored. Good news for the Bison, it was only 3 points. Bad news, Missouri State, nice drive. Sure wish we could have got 7.
Did take 5 minutes off the clock on that opening drive, and very good on third down as well. Converting 3 of 4.
Well, Missouri State, too, it was interesting. They, last week, as an offense, they had 4 drives of 11 plays or more. Last year, not last week, last year, that's how many the entire offense had all year.
So Drake to put the toe to it. And the Bison take it from their own two. Picking its way as Lance Dunn up to the 23-yard line. As we take a look at the North Dakota State offense and the starting lineup brought to you by Shields.
Easton Stig, Omaha, Nebraska.
Colin Connor, Mineral Point, Wisconsin.
Zach Johnson, Apple Valley, Minnesota.
Austin Cooter, Sioux Falls, South Dakota.
Jack Clankers, Leonard, North Dakota.
Landon Leckler, Beach, North Dakota.
Connor Wentz, Dunellen, Florida.
Chase Morlock, Moorhead, Minnesota.
Bing Frazier, Kansas City, Missouri.
RJ Erzendowski, Omaha, Nebraska.
Darius Shepherd, Blue Springs, Missouri.
A homecoming of sorts for Shepherd playing in his home state. And Shepherd is the motion man at a 32-yard touchdown run last week against Illinois State. Bison going to the ground game and a pretty good push up front, but the hole closes quickly after a gain of three by King Frazier. Here's a look at the Missouri State defense. Starting lineup also brought to you by Shields. Dylan Cole, the man to watch in the middle, had a fantastic game, was the FCS Stats National Player of the Week for his performance against the Sycamores.
Preseason All-American. Cole led the Bears in tackles last year in every game they played. He's playing a different position now. He's at the mic. He was a Will linebacker last year, so he's moved inside to the middle. You'll see him, number 31. He's all over the place.
Be sure the starting safety also having a very good season. Dropped in the flat to Nate Jensen, incomplete. Should have been an easy reception as we throw down to our sideline reporter, Beth Houle, for a report. Beth.
Hey, guys, as we first reported in our Farmers Union Insurance Bison football pregame show, Chase Morlock not along with the team today as he is dealing with a family emergency back in Fargo. His father battling cancer for about the last year, a little over a year now. Chase is at home. The coach is telling me that their thoughts and prayers are with Chase, and they're looking forward to winning one for the Morlock family today.
Thank you, Beth. Stick under pressure, and down he goes, back at the 17-yard line. And that is Colby Isbell, his fourth sack of the season.
Isbell was in there. There was also number 33 in that play as well. Hey, it's just when you're the Bears, Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, and you're going 4-on-5 and you can get the pressure, yeah, you're loving that. And the other thing, too, is NDSU is going to run a little bit more empty. We saw it there, empty meaning no running backs, so Stick doesn't have anybody there to help pick up that extra guy if they break free.
So on comes Jackson Kuntz, and pressure coming, and Kuntz was hit. Here comes a flag.
Cole got him.
Dylan Cole coming untouched, and Kuntz did get it off, and he's a hobbling off as the ball bounces down to the 34-yard line. So the question now is, will this be roughing or running into the punter?
Big difference on which one the official will decide to throw down.
Based on what we're seeing, it's running into the kicker from the reaction from Chris Kleiman on the far sideline.
Yeah, because Coach Kleiman is wanting the roughing penalty because that would mean a first down. It wasn't the greatest punt in the world either. So you see Cole 31 coming off the edge, and he's the one that hit him.
Running into the kicker. Return team, number 31. The penalty is, this would be a 5-yard penalty. Replay, fourth down.
And that's the other option that Coach Kleiman has, too, if you want to re-kick it. It was not the greatest punt in the world, we should say.
And Jackson Kuntz off to a bit of a slow start, the transfer from SMU. He's averaging just 34 yards a punt so far to start the season.
First down.
I think the penalty is actually going to be declined.
Also, they'll take the
and Missouri State will just take it at the 34, and that's what will happen. We come back. Missouri State on top, 3-0 early from here in Springfield. Back in Springfield, Missouri State getting set for their second offensive possession. So we take a look at our Bobcat game recap. 13 plays, 30 yards, ends with a 50-yard field goal by Drake to get the Bears on the board, but maybe more impressive, LT, 3-for-3 on their first third down conversions.
Yeah. Well, the Bears did one thing that Coach Polisic said we haven't done yet this year. That's score on an opening drive. So, NDSU can add another one to that column.
Lambert in the flat again. Picks up a few yards that time. Does Malik Earl.
This particular type of play, that's what Missouri State opened with last week. In fact, Earl again caught the first 6 plays of the game, and Lambert, the quarterback, completed his first 12 passes of the game. It's a really interesting look. Loaded to the field side, now motion into the field, I should say.
Randall makes the reception, buys in pursuit. Boy, Randall met right at the line of scrimmage.
Plank.
By Matt Plank.
But I tell you, he's been impressive so far today. His first reads have been spot on, and he is running downhill to that running back. Interesting play, though, because it started to the short side of the field, the boundary side, then you motioned to the field side or the wide side to balance it out, and then the play goes back to the boundary.
Empty backfield here with Lambert in the shotgun on third and 10. Lambert drops it in the flat, caught by Earl. Jalen Allison right there to force him out of bounds. Well short of a first down, and the Bears will have to punt.
That's the whole key, Brian, what you said there. Well short of a first down. It's a man-to-man situation against Earl, so you're playing it to make sure you don't give up the 10 yards. You'll give the under and make the tackle. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Allison doesn't really need help from Tucker, but it's coming, but played really well. And the Bison defense did exactly what it had to do after 13 plays in that first drive, get off the field on fourth down.
So Drake in to punt it away. A wobbler. Fair catch taken by Darius Shepherd at the 21-yard line. Still 3-0 Bears with 6:12 to go in the first quarter on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Missouri State Department of Athletics. 3-0 Missouri State midway through the first quarter. NDSU back on the field after a 3-and-out on their first possession. Frazier steps through one tackle. Good team pursuit that time by Missouri State as Darius Joseph comes in to finish off King Frazier after a gain of 3.
Well, Isbell, number 90, almost got that in the backfield. He was the trailing end on the play, trying to run it down from behind. Frazier had to do a pretty good job of just running through that initially.
Easton Stick. Quarterback comparison brought to you by the North Dakota Beef Commission. And Stick off to a fantastic start this season when you look at the numbers. 13 of 18, 256, and 3 touchdowns against ISU last weekend. Completing 65% of his passes, also running the football extremely well. 157 rush yards as well. Back to the power game, and again, Missouri State all over it. And again, it's Isbell, who's been very disruptive. No gain on that play.
Well, he is flying off the edge and coming hard. The Bison will find a way to take advantage of that initially. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, again, a little clear in. And then Jensen whiffs on the block. I mean, completely whiffs. And that's why that play goes nowhere. It was not even, you know, when you're crashing that hard, if you're not chipping the end, you're not even going to get to where the power play is designed to go. Third and long.
Stick in the face of pressure. Erzendowski tried to come back for the football. He was open, but the ball underthrown because Stick had pressure from Dylan Cole. Incomplete.
Missouri State does not bring blitzes a bunch. So here Cole came in, and he was right in the face of Stick, who was trying to set up and get the play downfield. But if you don't bring it a lot, then you don't prepare for it a lot. And keep in mind, the Bison are kind of without fullbacks. That's a lot of what the fullback's job is to do. Find who's coming on a pressure, whether it's A gap, B gap, where they're coming, get in front of him. Nobody got in front of Cole, and he put a pretty good lick on Stick.
So 2-3 and outs to start here offensively as Jackson Kuntz will punt this one deep again. And it bounces at about the 35-yard line and will take a nice Bison roll down to the 30. And that's where Missouri State will have it.
Early impression, though, Brian, for me, the speed at which Missouri State's defense is playing, very impressive.
Isbell, really one of those disruptive guys that Tim Polisek said, hey, when he's playing hard and he's doing things, he's a tough guy to handle. 7.5 tackles for loss, 3.5 sacks, both team highs.
You can save up to 30% touchdown Tuesdays at the Missouri State Bookstore.
So Lambert will bring the offense back out. After this timeout, you're watching the KBLY KFYR Bison Network. Four and a half left to go here in the first quarter. Missouri State, North Dakota State, both 1-0 in the Missouri Valley, and the Bears going to try to add to their 3-0 lead here. Inside handoff, that's Kalen Crowder, and again, the Bison all over. A trio of NDSU defensive players there, taken down for a loss of two.
Well, the Bears want to be able to run the ball today, Brian, and I just don't know if they'll be able to. I know they had success on the ground against the Sycamores last week, but I think they're going to have to rely on that guy.
And that is Brody Lambert coming off a tremendous performance, 279 yards and three touchdowns. As you take a look at the North Dakota Beef Commission quarterback comparison, Lambert will keep it. Lambert down for Earl, in and out of his hands. Trey Dempsey on the coverage, incomplete. Tuska applying pressure that time on Lambert.
Here's Jared Tuska, the defensive end, number 93, is who we're watching on the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Lambert again rolling out and getting hit as he put the ball in a pretty catchable spot as well. I think he's going to say, Earl, you need to help me on that. I stayed in to get this pass out to you. You need to make that catch. He had you said his numbers, but he had a career day for him last week.
Third and 12 coming up. Flag comes in. And a false start.
Prior to the snap. False start. Offense, number 65. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
And that is the center, Riley Schantz, the lone senior from right here in Springfield.
Schantz was one of those guys that this week when he was being interviewed was asked about NDSU and the pressure that they bring and all that, and he said, hey, they're good, bring it on, let's see what they got. he was pretty vocal about, hey, it's not K-State we're playing, it's North Dakota State.
Bison only bring a three-man pressure here, and Lambert drops it off to Furmanek. He gets back to about the 37, 8 yards short of a first down, and the Bears again will have to punt. This game today from beautiful Springfield, brought to you in high definition by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs.
The same situation to the Bison defense the previous possession for the Bears. Third and long, you're going to give it short, make the tackle, and get your offense back out on the field.
Back for North Dakota State, Darius Shepherd.
Darius Shepherd back deep at his own 30. Drake. This one kind of a wobbler, is going to bounce at about the 36, and Shepherd will let it bounce inside the 20, inside the 15, and down to the 10-yard line.
His long was 51. I think he just bested that. Excellent job by Drake flipping the field. I just talked about how he's punting kind of by default because the punter in the second game of the year got hurt.
So the Bison offense has only run six plays here in the first quarter.
Well, as the Bison come out, just let me correct one thing. I said that earlier on that play with Jensen that whiffed. No, that was Butler. Caleb Butler playing a little fullback that missed on that block. So that's some of the things the Bison are trying to do to make up for the fact that they don't have healthy fullbacks.
Yeah, unfortunately, Garrett Malmstrom has a PCL issue in his knee on Tuesday in practice, and he's been out the entire week. And Malmstrom, a great game last week, and Stick will go to the air. Stick on the deep out to Urzendowski, and he caught it. Urzendowski still on his feet to midfield, down to the Missouri State 48-yard line, and what an adjustment by the junior from Omaha.
Well, we saw his freshman year, his ability to do things just like this. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Stick sees the pressure, has to probably not get as set up as much as Stick wanted to. Little juggling catch, then Urzendowski towing the sideline. I thought he stepped out about the 48, but he kept on going to the other 48. And that's the big play the Bison needed. You negate the punt already. That in one play, it's wiped out the nice punt.
So really a shot in the arm for North Dakota State, 42 yards on that play. And that's a false start. I think the motion man lunged forward just a little bit quick.
I believe you saw that correctly.
Snap. False start, offense, number 8. 5-yard penalty.
Oh, he didn't step out. Yep.
The Bison will make a couple of substitutions here now on first and 15.
Well, we saw it last week, and again, you know, Stick's ability to throw long, it's pretty darn good.
Bison in that delta formation. The three running backs will Stick in the shotgun. Handoff outside. Goes to, I believe, Bruce Anderson. And Anderson gets up near midfield for a gain of three. And Anderson did not play last week, still dealing with a high ankle sprain.
So you have Dunn and Frazier and Anderson in that triangle backfield that's what the Bison called delta. Something Coach Polasek felt he would maybe use a little bit more.
Five receivers empty here for North Dakota State.
Bears will not bring pressure.
Stick fires in the flat to Shepard. And Shepard gains six up to the 44. Four will bring up third and six.
Defensive line for Missouri State will do a lot of stunting, meaning they'll run a lot of crosses and loops to try to get the Bison offensive line to miss on an adjustment. Successful early, but not so much on that play. But again, it was designed, and Stick got the ball out of his hand early.
North Dakota State 0 of 2 on third down today. Stick under pressure, and it's Isbell dropping Stick back at the 47.
He continues his solid play so far today. NDSU does not have an answer for the junior from Rogers, Arkansas. Again, the bottom of your screen is where he's coming from. And that's Plankers that should be trying to seal him off, and Jack never got a body on him. Speed, he's doing it with speed today. He's not big, 240.
Well, the long completion to Erzendowski at least gets the Bison to flip the field a little bit here. And that is the end of the first quarter. And so far, Missouri State up to the task. They lead it 3-0 on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard.
Well, the first drive of the first quarter produced the only points of the game. Since then, the defenses for both teams have been very good. This is R.J. Erzendowski making an adjustment on the catch. That's the biggest offensive play of the game as the Bison find themselves down, Brian, by 3 points here to start the second.
North Dakota State minus 6 rush yards so far. Missouri State minus 5 rush yards so far. So neither team able to move the ball so far here in the first quarter on the ground. Kuntz back deep. Kuntz drives Holloman back to his own 19. He makes the fair catch there. That's where Missouri State will start. This game brought to you in high definition by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs. And after that first drive, LT, North Dakota State has made the adjustment, certainly. So how does Missouri State counter those adjustments?
They're going to try to figure out. But I just don't think Missouri State's going to be able to run the ball today. And when you can't do that, it's a bunch of quick passes, trying to get to the edge and try to get your wide receiver group, which is your most experienced group, to make a play, make the Bison try and miss.
Lambert has time, fires across the middle, off the hands of LaMarcus Stewart, and incomplete. He had a step. On the Bison corner, Jalen Allison.
When you have time, you have an opportunity to complete a play like this because there is no safety on this play. Allison knows he's on an island. The play flow was to the near side or where your cameras are, so that's where Grimsley kind of sucked up and moved up, so the deep middle safety was open. That was a potential big play for Missouri State, but Allison covered it up.
Inside handoff, a crease slightly that time for Crowder. Gains about 5 yards to the 24. Crowder also had a huge game last week at Missouri State. 9 carries for 131 yards and 3 touchdowns.
Yeah, he had a 64-yarder in there as well. He had over almost 100 yards of touchdowns last week.
So a manageable third down situation here for the Bears, 3rd and 5.
But you still don't get a sense that even though you just gained 5 yards in that last play, I don't have a sense that the Bears can run the ball right here and feel like they can pick up a first down. I think the ball's going in the air.
Bison, stun up front, bring pressure. This ball floats out of bounds and incomplete. Malik Earl, the intended target. And Jaylon Winbush in on that coverage.
Earl stepped out of bounds anyway, so he would not be an eligible receiver to even catch that ball if it was completed in bounds because his step, he took 2 steps onto the white, so that play had no chance. Even if it was completed, it wouldn't have been completed.
So Shepard back deep at the 35.
But you're right, Brian. The Bison defense have certainly made the adjustment. Now it's on the offensive side to do things.
And that's kind of another low wobbler. The Bison will get away from it, and the ball will bounce to the 41-yard line before it's touched down by Austin Henderson, and that's where North Dakota State will have it. Still looking for their first points of the game. 3-0 here on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. A smattering of NDSU fans here in Springfield today. North Dakota State trying to get something going offensively.
Shift to unbalanced.
And a little bit of room that time for Frazier. Lunges ahead to about the 44 for 3 yards. Beth Hull on the sidelines has a report. Beth.
Hey guys, RJ Erzendowski, the guy to go to in the air for the Bison this year. He's leading the FCS in yards per reception, leading the Bison last week with his 65-yard touchdown reception against Illinois State. Coming into this game, he has three of the NDSU team's 5 longest receptions this season. That last one, 43 yards.
All right, thank you, Beth. Yeah, adding to that total, helping that average a little bit so far here today. Dunn getting outside, and Lance Dunn steps through a tackle from Cole and has a first down inside Missouri State territory, the 48.
But what do you do to a guy who's running you down from behind? You run at him. And Jeff Ilias and friends, look at Ilias on Isbell. Isbell's rolling on the ground, and the Bison are running for a first down. So that's one of the adjustments they made. Let's see how Isbell can do with people coming at him as opposed to him trying to go away from that speed. That's a part of Ilias's game that has come skyrocket, his blocking ability from where he started.
Stick under pressure again, drops it off. Had an open receiver. Bruce Anderson dropped it at the 48.
But that pressure was enough to get that ball to flow a little bit more to where the stick, he wasn't on target. It went off to his right, so it rolled out of his hand a little bit late.
Easton Stick, 2 of 5 for 48 yards so far here today.
Yeah, and Beth just said 43 of them on the one really nice adjustment that Erzendowski made. The Bison have to find a way to get success on the ground.
High snap, Stick is going to run it. Has some room inside the 45 to the 41. Flag comes in late.
Yeah, poor snap and a hold. That play is ugly.
Would have been a gain of close to 7, but I think it's coming back. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
Now you improvise. Now Stick knows the play. The timing of the play is all messed up, so he's just going to get what he can. Way back on the line of scrimmage, off to his left where the play was designed to go, there was a pile of people and a hold.
Holding, offense, number 75. 10-yard penalty, replay, 2nd down.
That is Austin Kuhner at the center. Tim Polasek mentioning to us, he believes Kuhner can play better than how he's played so far. But again, a late start for Austin. Missed the first few games.
Yeah, he had an academic issue. which cost him the first two games, came back and started against Iowa. And of course, we know how the Bison produced on the ground in that game.
So second and 20. Stick to the air, fires across the middle, and it is caught all the way down to the 41-yard line. Erzendowski makes another reception.
I have a little skinny post. Safety's deep, so you're probably not going to get it deep under a double coverage. You beat the corner, and Stick finally was able to deliver the ball, stepping into the throw, doing it on time, zipped it in there.
Bison go quick on third and three, and Dunn needed the 38, and he may have come up just a little bit short. We'll see where it's spotted.
If he's short, I wouldn't be surprised if NDSU goes for it here, and they could go quick on it. Yep, it's going to be fourth down. Another quick situation. The Bison are going to try to catch the Bears. Not allow the Bears to make any substitutions either. That's another big thing when you stayed lined up.
North Dakota State going for it on fourth and less than a yard. Stick needs to get to the 38, and I think he got just across the 38 and should have a first down.
Yeah, Missouri State knows what's coming. It's the quarterback sneak. They tried to plug both of the A gaps as much as possible, getting three and almost four people in there. But still, the Bison were able to get what they needed, and that was a yard, a little less than a yard, actually. Not surprised at all that Coach Kleiman went for it. Needs to keep his offense on the field.
Back to the ground, room to run that time for Frazier, and Frazier lunges ahead across the 25, down to the 23, enough for a first down.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. King Frazier, at the end of last year and all of this year, has been finishing his runs really, really strong. In the past, you may have seen him maybe try to tiptoe that thing or break it off to his left. No, he got what he could, and then a couple of yards more. Make sure you get the first down. Don't make a move and lose the first down.
Darius Daniel coming in to make the tackle there for Missouri State, and North Dakota State now inside the 25 with a first down. Flag comes in again. Boy, that was blocked really well.
That's
again.
Too bad, because the Bison had that play. They had what they wanted, and it's against NDSU on a motion. But they got the Missouri State defensive line shifting. They got them out of position, and that would have been a really good play.
Offense, number 64, 5-yard penalty, replay, first down.
Colin Connor, the sophomore from Mineral Point, Wisconsin, jumping a little bit earlier.
I think it was Skyler Hulls rather that they had moving all over the place. He was a little out of position. Linebacker was trying to get him to move. I don't know if it would have been a touchdown, but they'd have got a halfway to the touchdown on that play. But it didn't happen.
So first and 15 back at the 28. Go back to the run. And a strong finish again for Frazier up to the 20-yard line as we take a look at our trivia question brought to you by the North Dakota Soybean and North Dakota Corn Councils. One bushel of soybeans can yield how many gallons of biodiesel? We'll have the answer coming up. Any guesses, LT?
None. I could guess. That would be kind of like my ACT test, but... I think NDSU, I mean, still, it's second and long, but after that last penalty, they're finding something on the ground now.
Go to the ground again. Boy, not that time. There was all sorts of red jerseys at the line of scrimmage, and Dunn maybe lost a yard.
Boy, you're looking at Dylan Cole. 31 is one of the guys in there for sure. He had some help. But
Curran Blamey also.
Cole's the leading tackler on this team, and he really sticks his nose in there. One of the reasons too that Cole moved to the middle is because they think that if he's going to get some looks at the next level, it's because it will be as a middle linebacker. So Cole is able to move to the middle, and they also like the future, the redshirt freshman Eggman as well. So that's where Cole played last year. He's in the middle this year, and that last tackle puts the Bison offense in a tough spot.
Third and 8 for Stick. Stick on the sidelines. It's a little bit too high for Darius Shepherd. He was open, incomplete. And that might mean a field goal attempt here for Cam Peterson.
This is one of those that when Stick looks back on film, he's going to kick himself because he had his man, he had him hoping, he had him in time, but the quarterback missed.
Take a look at the answer to our North Dakota soybean and North Dakota Corn Council trivia question. One bushel of soybeans can yield how many gallons of biodiesel? The answer is 1.5 gallons. So Peterson on for the attempt from about 38 yards. Davis the holder, Fisher the snapper. It's down, it is up, and it is perfect. And we are tied at 3 as Camp Peterson connects from 38.
8:14 to go in the first half. Get your horns out.
We're tied up. 8:14 to go here in the second quarter on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Take a look at your Bobcats game recap. 11 plays, 59 yards, and just 5:34, and Peterson connects from 38 yards. So the Bison are at least on the board here and showing the ability to run the football that drive.
I think the NDSU needed to do that, Brian, and they did. They found a way to get it done on the ground, get the ball in scoring position, and then we're now tied.
Holloman on this Peterson Farm seat kickoff from the 6, and Holloman dangerous in the open field. Spun down at about the 25-yard line. And Eric Bachmeyer dealing with a PCL issue in his knee. They weren't sure how much he was going to be able to play today. Did not practice a ton this week.
I don't know if you saw the brace that Eric has on his right knee. And other than the opening drive, the Bison have been able to kind of take some of that rhythm away from the Bears offense. Lambert will try to get back into it.
Lambert 8 of 13 for 48 yards so far today. Holloman on the end around. Boy, that is closed off.
MJ
Stump. And he goes back to the 22-yard line is where they'll mark forward progress. But yeah, MJ Stump, the Harvey Hornet coming in there to take care of that one.
Beautiful physical play. He's playing the outside linebacker, Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. You see him read, run. He throws himself in the middle of both blockers and then even gets in on the tackle. Beautiful job by MJ Stump.
Loss
That's
of,
good stuff.
Loss of 3.
Again, I know the Bears are going to want to try and run the ball today, Brian. I don't think they'll be successful at it.
Lambert fires, intercepted. Jalen Wimbush comes up with it on an errant throw from Lambert, and the Bison take advantage. Was that Allison?
No, that's
it.
It
was Jalen Allison.
This is just a poor pass.
Jalen Allison coming up with the pick.
His feet were set. He tried to get it into Furmanek. Tried to squeeze it past Stump. Couldn't do it. Here will be a really good look at it. I don't know where he thought he could try to get that ball in there. His window did not exist to complete that ball, and Allison with the pick.
Second interception of the season for the sophomore from Papillion, Nebraska. And the North Dakota State offense back on the field.
Looking to get 6. The Bison tied it up the last time they had the ball. Plenty of time here before half. They're looking to pound this one in.
Stretch play to Bruce Anderson. Has a blocker in front, and Anderson around the edge. Bruce Anderson! If he's not out of bounds, it's a touchdown, but a flag is out.
They might call chop block. Ilias was throwing the block on the edge, and it might be too low. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Watch 86, Jeff Ilias. Oh, we miss his first contact, but he rolls through the legs of the defender, and I think that's what's going to be called.
Holding offense. Number 20.
Oh, no. Away from that.
From the spot of the foul. First down.
So Darius Shepherd called for the infraction.
Some penalties are worse than others. The penalties that take points off the board, the absolute worst thing can happen.
So first and 13, if they mark the penalty off from the spot of the foul, which they are doing.
So Ilias's block was clean. That was good to know. And then, well, I think Shep just got a little bit of a jersey when he was trying to block Joseph, I think, on the edge.
Frazier met right in the hole. Stopped in his tracks by Curran Blamey after a gain of one.
His first start of the year, Blamey's fighting a little bit of an injury. Eric Greeley's played a lot of snaps, so the Bears are real happy to have number 35 back out there playing some defense. Stick changing the play.
Done. Again, stopped in his tracks. Good job again by Missouri State. Isbell, among others. Egbim also got in there. Just a redshirt freshman linebacker from Rowlett, Texas.
Egbim's second on the team to Cole in tackles. And again, we talked about how his emergence as a player helped the Bears be able to move Cole inside. Tough spot for the Bison offense here, third and 10.
Stick has time, throwing downfield for Shepherd. Touchdown!
Bailed himself
Darius
out.
Shepherd, 21-yard catch.
After the
touchdown,
hole,
North Dakota State.
To potentially stall the drive, now you score the touchdown. That's what the Bison needed. Into the end zone. This is a beautifully thrown ball.
Easton Stick, plenty of time in the pocket.
No.
Yeah, that is about as good as it gets.
At about the 8-yard line, that's when Shepherd kind of created the space he needed to get open. He made a move right inside the 10 that got him away from the corner to allow Stick to lay it right in there.
All set up by the Allison interception. Peterson adds the extra point. Flag comes in.
Well, you see where Fisher, the snapper, is? He's back at the 8-yard line. You're not supposed to hit the snapper. I wonder if this is what was called.
The extra point was good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can't roll that guy like you used to.
Personal foul, roughing the snapper, number 99 on the defense. The penalty will be assessed on the kickoff, 15 yards.
EJ,
timeout.
EJ Sutton.
EJ Sutton whistled for the penalty. 5:45 to go. North Dakota State has its first lead of the game on a 21-yard touchdown pass from Easton Stick to Darius Shepherd, the Missouri native, putting the Bison on top. Back in Springfield, this game brought to you in high definition by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs. North Dakota State taking advantage of the turnover. Just four plays.
Could
for them
be a
to punch it in.
Real important part of the game, the next 5 minutes for the Bears.
Cam Peterson on for the Cam Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. And again, Peterson had the ball at the 50, so not a whole lot of work for him to push this one out of the end zone. We'll take a look at our Bobcat game recap. Four plays, 21 yards, and just 140. And Shepherd capping it off on a big third down completion by Stick.
Yeah, Shepherd was one who was called for the hold, and he got that touchdown. And Shepherd, you mentioned it too, kind of, you know, from Blue Springs, is less than 3 hours from here up the road. He was 27-1 his last 2 years on the teams he played in high school. So he's, what, 59-4 so in games played for Shep the last couple handful of years.
Not bad. Inside handoff, room this time to the outside. And that is Randall to the 36. Good enough for a first down, gain of 11. Wimbush came in to make the tackle.
Yeah, and he needed to because he's the guy that blows the cup. Watch 23, he gets kind of sandwiched a little bit inside, got himself caught. Coaches talk about keeping the cup, meaning don't allow any spot for that to break down. The outside of it is what broke down when Bush got caught.
Bears go back to the ground game, not this time. Randall swallowed up right back at the line of scrimmage, actually lost a yard.
Now that stump making a read initially. He also gets Tangway 99 in on that particular tackle. The interiors of both defenses today, I think, have looked real fast. They're playing with some real good speed inside.
Lambert to throw. Bison bringing pressure. Lambert across the middle, and he had an open receiver on Malik Earl, but could not step into the throw.
Well, that's because Tuska was coming on him. And that is where your pressure helps your defensive back, or your you know. Because if he was able to just have a half a second more, this pass is probably completed. Lambert did not have that opportunity because 93 was bearing down on him.
So third and long again for Missouri State. 3 for 3 on their first third downs. They are 0 for 4 since. And Earl jumped offside on the hard count by Lambert, and that will cost the Bears 5. And now a tough third
offense,
down conversion.
Number 17
gets even tougher.
5-yard penalty, third down.
On these third and 15s, last few times, Bison have elected to go with coverage more than pressure. That's what it looks like here. It'll be a coverage play.
And another false start. Mm-hmm. This one's going to go on Jordan Turner, the sophomore.
False start. Offense, number 77. 5-yard penalty, third down.
Turner, one of the 15 returning starters for Missouri State, and he is, as you mentioned, the sophomore, so he played and learned under fire last year as a true freshman. Which actually says a lot about his ability, because the old line is the further you get away from the ball, the earlier you can generally play in your college career. So as a guard, you have to have ability as a true freshman to be able to hang in there and play that spot.
Lambert had the ball knocked out of his hands. Is it a live football? The Bison say yes, the officials say yes. NDSU's got it.
Is that Stanley Jones that had the football?
I think so. Number 94, the sophomore from Bismarck.
Tangway, among others, putting pressure up the middle. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. We'll get another look to see if Lambert's arm was going forward. Now, ball knocked away. Jones sees it and makes the adjustment to the ball once it hits the turf. Well, before that offensive possession, I talked about the last 5 minutes or so, how important it would be for Missouri State. Now the Bison have a golden opportunity to really dig that hole a little bit deeper here late in the first half. And NDSU generally takes advantage of situations like this if you give them that.
And I think the officials may look at this.
But this gives us an opportunity to talk a little bit more about NDSU is outscoring its opponents 34-3 after turnovers this year. And here the Bison coming off another turnover.
It doesn't appear like the play will be reviewed. So North Dakota State football. Stick rolls out, fires in the flat to Connor Wentz. But again, the pressure got to him and he sidearmed it into the ground. Incomplete.
Well, Isbell is really unblocked on this play, and it's by design. But again, he's shown us some pretty good speed. So Stick was unable to get the shoulders back squared up and get the ball back out to Wentz. Now, Wentz runs past Isbell because he's not blocking him. You try to influence him a little bit. Didn't work. Blew up the timing. Second down.
Play action again. Stick, wide open receiver downfield. Stick didn't see him. And now he's just going to unload it incomplete as pressure was coming.
I think the Bison,
flag came in.
I think Bison got a hold, wasn't it? But yeah, Connor Wentz was wide open. Stick didn't see him. Then he tried to just get it late, hoping Wentz would come back to the ball after the play kind of blew up.
Second
offense, number 75, 10-yard penalty, second down.
That's Coonert again. Second time he's been called. Let's take a look at our new seed fan cam.
Second and 20 from the Missouri State.
Bison fans hoping their team can punch this one in and put some more distance between the Bison and the Bears. Second and 20.
Lucky.
Bruce Anderson dropped it, came back up to him, but he's not going to get much. Cole and Isbell there after a gain of two.
Real lucky that that bounced right back up to Anderson and he was able to kind of keep going. I mean, at that point, you just don't want to give the ball back. Hand off, disrupted. Cole was in there. And who, number 90 was around that play as well. Boy, he's played a good half.
He's been active. So third and 18 coming up for the Bison.
That's the guy we're talking about being active.
Stwick looked like he was going to run. Now he's going to throw, going to the end zone for Ilias.
Fly
incomplete. Cameron Price, the safety, in on coverage for Missouri State.
Now that ball hung in the air just long enough for Price to regain what he lost. I mean, he read run first on that, broke in a couple of steps. Ilias tried to get deep, and Stick just didn't quite lead him enough. Well-designed play, though.
So that will bring out Peterson for a 51-yard field goal attempt.
He had the 52-yarder inside skim off the top of the crossbar earlier this year.
And North Dakota State will call a timeout here with 3:34 to go.
Timeout. Play clock was down to one.
Their first charge timeout of the half. This will be a 30-second timeout.
Missouri State's defense comes up big, really takes advantage of that holding penalty, which drives NDSU back 10 yards, and that's what makes this attempt very difficult for Peterson.
Yeah, the Bears taking advantage of that NDSU mistake.
Well, the Bison up to 128 yards of total offense. And the rush yard total, still probably not where Tim Polasek would like it at just 42, but after having minus six in the first quarter, let's step in the right direction.
I mean, if you remember back to the game at the end of the year where these two teams played in the Fargo Dome and it was over before it started, I mean, you can see the progress that Missouri State has made. I mean, they're more mature. Coaches will tell you they understand our system much better. Physically, they look a lot tougher, and the 51-yard field goal is not going to happen.
The offense now back on the field for North Dakota State. Fourth and 18. And now Missouri State's going to burn a timeout.
Timeout, Missouri State. Their first charge timeout of the half. This will be a 30-second timeout.
Coach Steckel may be caught off guard a little bit by that move from Chris Kleiman.
I was half maybe thinking that Stick might just punt the thing.
He still might. Dave Steckel this week was asked about Easton Stick, was very complimentary of him, said he's so impressed with him, he's talented, intelligent. And then one of the reporters asked, well, at least you've seen him before because Carson Wentz was hurt. And he goes, well, the team saw him. I didn't see him.
Yeah.
I just had retina surgery, so I had these glasses on, so I didn't see anything after that. But the team has seen him.
Yeah, one of the reporters here in Springfield was asked Coach Steckel about that retina surgery. He was asked if that was the toughest test of your life. And he goes, you ever been to Paris Island, question mark? Well, Paris Island is a Marine training facility in South Carolina because Coach Steckel was in the Marines back in the 70s. So he said, yeah, no. Eye surgery compared to the Marines, nothing.
Well, North Dakota State has one fourth down conversion today.
Bunch of pre-snap movement. Erzendowski now on the wide side of the field.
And Stick will punt it. Drops it out of bounds. Pretty good job by Easton Stick. First career punt inside the 15-yard line.
I knew we hadn't seen it before, but there's just something in my gut telling me that we might see him punt it. And Stick's not happy with himself. He got it out inside the 20, but he was probably thinking more inside the 10. But a bullet dodged if you're Missouri State.
Absolutely, after the turnover. We've seen North Dakota State just jump on other teams' mistakes over the years, and that is what quickly can distance now, the rest of the pack from the Bison.
Now, Earl's a downfield playmaker. I mean, Holloman's not out there right now, so Earl's their guy. He's in the slot, so he'll be interested to see what they do with him.
Boy, a lot of pads crunching down there, field side.
Now, the Bison certainly were reading run on that particular play as well.
Kalen Crowder, tackled by Nate Tangway.
They took Grimsley, I believe, was the safety on that play out in, who was on the slot. He snuck down inside the box. They went man outside thinking run.
Bears changing things up after going up tempo to start. Crowder met in the backfield. Man alive, are the Bison defensive linemen in the backfield.
Menard this time just blows past his guy. Doesn't get a hand or a body on him. He might have got a hand on him, but Menard just so quick off the ball. Made a little bit of an inside move. There you're looking at Aaron Steidel, the guy who forced a huge fumble in the last week in the first half. Both defensive lines playing well today.
So third and 10 for the Bears. Lambert to throw. Lambert plenty of time in the pocket. Now he's running out of time. And he just throws it away.
When your inner clock starts ticking and then it ticks almost 2 seconds later than when you want to get rid of that ball, you know there's white jerseys coming after you. Lambert, not there. He wants the ball out of his hand now. And now he knows he needs to run because there's some big boys coming after me.
Brad Ambrosius that time from the backside applying the pressure. And again, a three and out as Missouri State, really since the first drive, has not mustered much of anything.
They tried to run the ball twice. I was a little surprised. I thought maybe they would be more aggressive on that particular series late in the half, but not aggressive at all.
Zach Drake. Another kind of low wobbler. Shepard will call for the fair catch at the 45, and that will save some field position for the Bison, who have 159 to work with and two timeouts.
Previous couple of punts, he failed to do that. That time, I'm sure Shepard was being coached up to be more aggressive. Get that thing in the air. Don't allow it to hit. The last two did hit. The one before kind of bounced sideways, but two punts ago, the one in the end of the first quarter really had a big run on it. So nice job by Shepard to make that adjustment. And again, the Bison here have plenty of opportunities to be aggressive. Two timeouts, almost 2 minutes.
Stick 4 of 10 for 86 yards and a touchdown here in the first half. But he's been harassed a little bit, especially by Isbell.
He's been pretty good on his deep balls, but Stick just hasn't found his timing today yet.
Inside handoff this time, and Frazier pushes the pile ahead to about the 42, gain of 3. Tristan Crowder got in there. Stick time across the middle, tight window there, caught to the 31-yard line.
Jensen.
Nate Jensen makes his first reception of the day.
Now after the first down, NDSU, Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, real nice pass away from where Cole was. Let his receiver's hands get out in front of him.
Again, up high, and boy, how about that catch?
That's Shepard,
beautiful catch by Darius Shepard across the middle.
Now Shepard running a little bit of a post, probably about a 10 yards, and then a hard cut inside, get in front of the safety. Here he is, around the backer, in front of the safety. Good catch, Bison back on offense.
Frazier Not much, a couple to the eight. We're now ticking down towards a minute to go here in the first half. And again, NDSU plenty of time, plus they have the two timeouts.
Tackle by McNeese Eggbum.
And the Bison will take one of their timeouts.
North Dakota State, their second charge timeout of the half. This will be a 30-second timeout.
And NDSU can still get a first down if they get to the one.
Thirty-one of Coach Kleiman's 34 head coaching games at NDSU have ended in victory.
Take a look at the new seat fan cam.
That's a suntan day today.
It is. NDSU fans taking advantage of it. T-shirts and shorts. McNeese Eggbum made that last tackle. Interesting guy, really came out of nowhere, born in Nigeria. And he, like so many of these Missouri State Bears, are just so young, LT. I mean, they've certainly grown, but you got a lot of freshmen and sophomores playing out there.
Well, you got a lot of experience last year. Nobody likes getting their brains beat in, which is exactly what happened last year. So you work in the off. If you want incentive in the offseason, Missouri State's 1-10 last year is incentive. Here's Zandowski, 1-1 on the outside. Looks good.
Stick's going to keep it. Stick inside the five, takes on a tackler, runs him over, and gets inside the five down to the 3-yard line.
Well, but Darius Daniel did his job, though. He ran him over, but he got in the way. He kept him out of the end zone.
Third and three from the Bear 4-yard line.
Third and three. Stick back to throw, lofts it up to the back of the end zone, and a little bit too tall for Jeff Ilias, incomplete.
Pass intended for Jeff Ilias.
Of the tight end group for NDSU, Ilias, he's the best pass catcher. In fact, Coach Hedberg said this guy could, meaning Ilias, he could play wide in some wide receiver spots. That's how much they like his ability to catch the ball, but that was just a little bit too tough of an opportunity.
Ken Peterson into attempt.
So the Bison will settle for a field goal attempt. This will be a 21-yard attempt for Peterson, who is 1 of 1 today. And he drills this with no problem. So Bison able to extend the lead with 27 seconds to go until halftime.
But Missouri State's happy that it's only three. I think if NDSU puts a touchdown on the board, it makes a much bigger impact on the second half of this game.
Once again, this game brought to you in high definition by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs. And the Bears, not a lot to cheer about here in the second quarter. It's been tough. Tough sledding.
Offensively.
Yes.
Yes. I assumed that's what you meant.
Absolutely.
I was just surprised by the last possession from Missouri State. To me, with the couple of handoffs, it just seemed like they were playing to get to halftime.
And maybe they were.
They gave up, you know, a few more points.
Maybe the two turnovers having something to do with that too, LT. Just 56 total yards for Missouri State here in the first half.
That's all, huh?
That's it. Wow. And only eight of those are on the ground. So running the football, as we mentioned, they wanted to run it, but it's just not happening today.
And the fact that NDSU has not run the ball as well as the Bison wanted to, as you know, that's another credit, I think, to Missouri State's defense, which is one of the reasons that we're sitting with only 16 points scored combined.
Peterson going to kind of pooch this one. Taken at the 30 by one of the up men. And he is taken down back at the 35. That's a backup tight end, Adam St. Peter.
Yeah, a lot of times you just throw that arm up in the air and make the fair catch.
Well, and again, we should mention it. I mean, Missouri State, they are fifth in the country in rush defense, giving up just 77 yards a game. The level of competition has certainly not been to what North Dakota State has faced, and they are sixth in the country. Seven plays. Minute 32, capped off by Cam Peterson from 21 yards. The drive going about 41 yards.
Yeah, you're right. The Bears defense allowing is first in the Missouri Valley, less than 300 total yards a game, so that's pretty good.
Conservative play call here as Randall gets the carry, gains two up to the 37, and that will likely be the final play of the half.
Well, I guess I thought maybe NDSU would make him make one more snap, but no.
Second and eight from the Bears' 37-yard line.
That'll do it for the end of the first half. North Dakota State leads it 13-3. After trailing by three early, Chris Kleiman's bunch has rattled off 13 straight. Beth Houle will try to catch a word here with head coach Chris Kleiman. And Coach Kleiman is now with Beth.
All right, guys, here with Coach Chris Kleiman. Coach, held their team to less than 60 yards there on offense. What can you say about your defense?
Defense is playing really well. We gave up the first drive, give Missouri State credit. We just got to relax on offense. We have some opportunities, and we've got to capitalize them on the second half.
Some turnovers have turned to points on the board, though. What have you learned from those experiences on the field?
Well, we just got to keep taking advantage of them. We need to get seven, not three.
Thanks, Coach. Guys?
Beth, thanks so much. Chris Kleiman. And the Bison lead it by 10. Stay tuned for the Proceed Halftime Report. Alex Egan and Ryan Gellner standing by. Back in the studio. Alex, Ryan, thank you very much. Chris Kleiman and his bunch going to try to build on a 10-point lead. And Missouri State, we talked about the struggles in the first half, LT, in that second quarter, just 10 total yards on offense.
10 yards, that was it. The Bison had 127 total yards in that second quarter. So that was really, the Bison took control of the game there, but the scoreboard doesn't necessarily show it. So this could be a really big drive for NDSU's offense. I thought if the Bison scored that late touchdown, they got the field goal to make it 13-10, that might have been the touchdown that helps separate these two teams. This is an opportunity right here on the opening drive of the second half to do the same.
And back deep for North Dakota State is the redshirt freshman Ty Brooks. Fargo South Bruin getting an opportunity here to start the second half to take this kickoff from Zach Drake. Another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. Brooks from the five. Brooks tiptoeing his way through and squirts ahead to about the 26-yard line. Egbim and that tackle.
Oh, the Bison's quarterback's not having his best day. We know that at least in the first half. So you would have to assume that NDSU is going to want to continue to try to establish that ground game and take some time of possession and put it in your pocket.
Stick 6 of 13 for 117 yards and a touchdown in the first half. Had a couple of opportunities, and balls underthrown, a couple balls overthrown.
But remember, out of that 117 was Erzendowski's really nice catch, so he kind of bailed him out. So you take that 43 off, and that's not a lot of production through the air.
And they're going to the ground game. Big hole that time as Lance Dunn lunges ahead for a gain of close to eight. Dylan Cole came in, Egbim also in there.
Trying to run physically off the edge. Nodak Mutual Insurance, it's a G play. You see the pulling guards. Again, Jeff Ilias putting somebody to the ground, and really nice block. That's the type of first down production the Bison are looking for. You get 6 yards on first down, and you're doing something right.
Three tight ends for North Dakota State. Quick slant, stick. Right on the money that time to Erzendowski. Good enough for a first down to the 37.
Now the high school buddies connecting up, needing 4 yards for the first down, a 5-yard pickup. So much of that is determined by how the corner is playing the wide receiver. Are you hedging inside? Are you hedging out? Hedging outside. He's on outside half of your body. You run upfield 4 steps, make a cut, deliver it on time, first down.
Erzendowski now 3 catches, 65 yards on the day. Frazier, King Frazier. Boy, look at some strong running as he carries 4 Bears all the way to the 48-yard line.
This was blocked fairly well, as you know, and it was again, I think, an outside G type of a play. Nodak Mutual Insurance. You see the pullers. No, it's a pin and pull. The center comes out as well. And then it's just, well, I gained 5 yards with the blocking, and now I'm going to gain the next 5 yards with my muscle.
Darius Joseph finally slammed him to the turf after a first down. Gain of 11 that time for King. Stick to the air. Fires in the flat, low, but it's caught. Nice job by Jeff Ilias adjusting to the football. Gain 7.
Ben Elfson was the guy who was running a little bit of a deeper route on that play. And because of where Elfson was, the flat was open.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
Pickup of 7 or 8 on first down. Play caller's dream, second and short.
Just the first catch of the day for Jeff Ilias.
Missouri State loading up the box.
And Bruce Anderson bouncing off tacklers, finally taken down by Dylan Cole. Close to a first down, maybe a yard short.
Isbell thinks he should have made that play. And he made him all those plays in the first half, but that's who Anderson was able to get away from and then search close to the first down marker, which he's a yard short.
Third and one coming up. North Dakota State not great on third down in that first half, just 1 of 8.
Well, terrible is another way to put it.
Connor Wentz in motion. Frazier, good surge, and King Frazier almost busted out of that pile. He still has a first down up to the 39.
Well, we've seen him do that a lot of times. You put so much effort into trying to not prevent that 1 yard that when you get that, King has been able to bounce off a tackler and then take it big. And you're right, Brian, that he was real close to doing that on that play. But NDSU's offensive line looks much more physical here on this first drive than it did in the first half.
Darius Daniel coming up from his corner position to make the tackle. Play action this time for Stick. Airs it out. Beautifully thrown football right on the money. And it is caught. Darius Shepherd makes the catch at the 22. Enough for a first down.
These are the types of patterns that last year they used a lot with Stick. You kind of flood the zone. You give him 3 different looks. You take half the field away. There's a deep man, a short man, and a middle man. And he hits the middle guy, and that is Shepherd.
So the Bison much more crisp this half to start the game. North Dakota Beef Commission quarterback comparison, 117 yards in that first half, 6 completions, 13 attempts, and the touchdown. But Stick sticking that one in there.
Yeah, I think you're right. He really looked good on that throw. Comfortable.
Oh, Bruce Anderson wrapped up by Blamey after a gain of 2.
Again, Anderson playing with a high ankle sprain, and Coach Polisek said the one thing that worries you with the type of ankle issue that Anderson has is if he's pulled down from behind. Those are the types of things that tend to aggravate it a little bit more.
They went through that last year with Chase Morlock, who's never quite get him healthy. Stick is going to keep it to the short side of the field, cuts it back inside, taken down at about the 14-yard line. In that time to make the tackle was backup linebacker Alex Jones.
Yeah, Cameron Price, the free safety playing deep middle, overran the play. So I thought that Stick had an opportunity to break that one if he could get past that first line. Because if a quarterback has a long run, it's generally because the safety made a mistake. Well, the safety made a mistake, but his teammates bailed him out. Good looking drive the Bison have going.
Third and 2. Frazier tiptoes a little bit, then he sneaks through another hole and has a first down, taken down by Cole at the 9.
Tackled by Dylan Cole.
This is the type of drive I thought we would see, Brian. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, unbalanced. And the Bison basically telling Missouri State, we're going to run it over here, We don't think you can stop us for these 2 yards.
Saw Caleb Butler back in there again, the backup defensive lineman for North Dakota State, getting some reps here at fullback today.
The Bison break down their red zones into four different categories, so now they're inside the 10.
And Landon Leckler.
False start, offense, number 78, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Well, there's a series of plays that are on the call sheet that the Bison have, and their red zone for the coaches starts at the 25. So he goes from the 25 to the 18, 17 to 14, 13 to 9, and then the 8 to the 3-yard line. So now they're, because of that penalty, back at the 14-yard line. So they look and see their series of plays from 17 to 14 and pick which one they think will work.
So this is first and goal at the 14 after the penalty. Dimitri Williams on the end around. Good pursuit that time by Bishore. And a flag comes in late.
Yeah, Bishore closed well.
May have been a face mask. Let's take another look at it. Nodag Mutual Insurance replay.
Yeah, it was Bishore grabbing the helmet. You might say he didn't get the face mask.
Personal foul, face mask. Defense, number 30. Half the distance to the goal. Automatic first down.
If you grab a helmet and opening, if you grab the ear hole, if you grab the back of the helmet, it's all called face mask, whether you grab the face mask or not.
And that really hurts, because not only is it half the distance, but it's a first down.
Yeah, this just appears to be a drive that is certainly going to end up in the end zone.
Well, when you think about it already, LT, North Dakota State has taken almost 7 minutes off the clock already.
7-yard line, first and goal. Now, for the Bison, this drive has been a thing of beauty.
Frazier lost the football. And Missouri State saying they have it. And they do.
Well, it was a thing of beauty right up until the fumble.
Alex Jones came up with it. Isbell was in there, I think, to jar it loose. Nodag Mutual Insurance replay.
Actually, I think it was Cole. Cole was moved from his middle spot to the outside, provided some edge pressure. Isbell was in on the play, but I think it might have been Cole that got his hand on that. Just like the first half, the Bison offense leaving some points out there on the field.
A drive that lasted almost 7 minutes, and NDSU comes up with nothing. Lamp to the quick game on the pass, and this is Malik Earl into the flat. He lost the football.
Down.
But they're calling it down by contact. MJ Stump came over. Trey Dempsey was in there.
Down by big contact. He was hit pretty hard.
Jalon Wimbush came in, but boy, MJ Stump is having himself a game today.
Looks like Missouri State wants to try to pick up the pace here a little bit.
Gain of 7 there on first down.
Interesting spot to put Holloman. He's the big speed guy.
Oh, man. How about MJ Stump today?
Oh, he's having a great day.
Plank also in there.
A lot of misdirection.
It was really MJ Stump that made the play.
Quite a bit of misdirection in the backfield, trying to see what Stump is doing, you know, taking the linebacker away. But when you read pulling guards, you're reading run. Neither of those pullers were able to get in front of the man from Harvey.
That was a loss of 2. So now 3rd and 4 coming up for the Bears. Lambert to Earl, complete. First down for Missouri State. That's their first 3rd down conversion since the opening drive of the game.
Just a deep square in. Lambert needs time. Bison put some pressure on right over the top of Tucker and laid it in there. One of his best throws of the day, if not the best.
Jalon Wimbush, pretty good coverage there on Earl. Lambert drops it off to Holloman, who is upended by Trey Dempsey after a gain of 2. Whoa!
The old 360 in the air.
Nodi Mutual Insurance replay. And how about the junior from Lakeland, Florida?
Again, Holloman's the speed guy. The Bears want to get him in space, and he had some space. But if that's the case, you need to make the tackle, and that was tackled with a little extra flair. Nice job, Dempsey.
Pressure coming on Lambert, gets rid of it, and dropped by Furmanek. And boy, did Lambert take a shot that time.
Ooh, Bison came clean. No one got a chance to slow down the man who hit Lambert. He did take a pretty good shot. You see him swear around his stomach and his ribs. He has the big, thick flak jacket on, and he needed it on that play.
Here's your quarterback comparison brought to you by the North Dakota Beef Commission in the first half for Lambert, who was pretty sharp on the opening drive, and then things kind of fell apart. Had a fumble that was recovered by North Dakota State, threw a pick to Jalen Allison. Lambert still can't find anybody, now drops it off to Crowder, who needs to get to the 37 for a first down, and he got to the 39.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, Bison and Nickel. It ran at least three verticals on this play to clear out the underneath. When nothing is open deep, you make your check down reads and let your running back get the first down.
So Missouri State back-to-back third down completions, and Kalen Crowder really did a lot of the tough work on that one. Now Randall in the Wildcat, trying to work off a couple of blocks on the outside. Picks up two.
Jones squeezes him, running down the line from behind. One of the guys in there on the tackle. I think Blake Williams is also in on that tackle as well.
Again, the Bears looking to go up tempo. Lambert drops it off in the flat. And a positive play there for Randall. Gains maybe three up to the 44. Beth Houle, our sideline reporter, has a report for us. Beth.
Hey, guys. I got to catch up with Coach Steckel there coming out of the locker room at halftime. He was fired up and lit a fire under his team, upset with the turnovers that they've given up to NDSU. He says, in a real obvious way, that's the way you give away a football game. Of course, right now, they're benefiting from one of those as they look to turn this game around for the Bears.
Beth, thanks so much. Caleb Butler checks in to defensive line here on third down. Lambert swings it out, caught by Earl, and he is a little bit short of a first down as the Bison hang on. Dom Davis, Jalen Allison all in there. We'll bring up fourth and one.
I think you go for it. The way NDSU showed the dominance on the ground, I think you keep your offense out there and go for it. You picked up a couple of third downs on this drive. Now you need to pick up a fourth down. Yeah.
And Coach Steckel leaving the offense on the field. And now he's going to try to make a quick change, but the play clock is already down to 12. This is going to be tough.
Might be able to get the snap off, but you better hurry.
And if they got it off, they just barely did as Drake puts the toe to it. Erzendowski back deep, lets it bounce inside the 10, inside the 5. Down to the 3-yard line, and North Dakota State will be pinned way back. When we come back, it's 13-3 Bison on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Today's broadcast brought to you in high definition by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs. A rapidly moving third quarter. North Dakota State driving down inside the 10, coming up with nothing. The Bears moving the football a couple of third down drives, and then on fourth and short, deciding the last second to punt it away.
And it was a good decision, obviously, because Bison have it on their own two. Worst field position, worst starting field position for NDSU today.
And they'll go to the power game. Not much there for King Frazier. Greeley looked like he might have been in there to make the tackle.
Let's go back to that opening drive and to not get points out of that. Boy, NDSU's offense has I'm going to say left at least, what, two touchdowns out there?
Stick will operate out of the shotgun here on second and eight. Pretty good room that time as Frazier powers ahead across the 10. We'll bring up third and short.
Well, he's finishing his runs well. Actually, he's finishing today about like he did against Iowa, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, he's really running through tackles. I mean, he took Dylan Cole for a ride there before Egbin could bring him down.
That's another almost 4 or 5 yards after initial contact. Anderson in at tailback now, double tight.
Bruce Anderson off to the races, and look out! There goes Anderson. He's got to outrun Cole, and he can't quite do it. Taken down at the 35.
Here's your biggest offensive play of the game for NDSU on the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. What great block on the edge. I think that was Johnson. And then Cole from his middle linebacker spot prevents the touchdown.
And the Bison pop a big one there, 53 yards.
They flip the field on the ground. That's hard to do.
Outside handoff this time. More room to run on the outside for Lance Dunn, and he gets inside the 30-yard line, and North Dakota State maybe starting to wear down that defensive front from the Bears here in the second half.
Fantastic production on first down, getting it all the way to about the length of a ball inside the 30. Bishore had to run him out of bounds. Bishore, we have not said his name much today, which is a little surprising, so the Bison have been able to take care of the strong safety. Remember Schafitzel, who was so good here for a long time, he's playing that position.
Schafitzel was just a thorn for North Dakota State. Always seemed to come up with a big play. Dimitri Williams comes up with the catch for a first down at the 25-yard line.
Play designed to pick up the first down, but I thought Stick did a pretty good thing with his eyes. He glanced to his left, the wide side of the field, to try to hold maybe a safety or the outside linebacker from getting out in the flat real quick.
Now under a minute to go here in the third quarter, which has really buzzed along. Ellison motions to the top of your screen. Oof. That time the Bears were all over it. Egbin got in there along with Holes. Tristan Crowder.
Looked like Leckler got up real slow on that after that play, but he's up. You see number 78.
No gain on that play.
Well, if you're Missouri State, you have to sell out on the plays you know NDSU is going to run, and that's some type of a power designed play within the tackle box, whether you're going A, B, or C gap.
And that will do it for the third quarter, which flew by here in Springfield. Score has not changed. 13-3 is going to be your score as we go to the fourth. And yes, it's the fourth quarter, so raise your four for the 4 for 4 from PetroSurf USA, where you can get a pizza, 2 cookies, and a drink for $4 every day at all 24 PetroSurf USA locations. We'll be back with the final 15 from Springfield after this. Fourth quarter, let's take a look at the New Seed fan cam. Pretty good representation of green and gold in the stands today here in Springfield.
Boy, with weather we've had today, why wouldn't you drive down and come and watch this thing?
Fans young and old taking this one in on the KVLY KFYR Bison Network. Second and 10 at the 25 for North Dakota State. Play action for Stick. Airing it out for Shepherd. Again, it is incomplete. Just a little bit to the outside. Bishore was in on that coverage for Missouri State.
Well, Bison taking a shot from the 25-yard line. One of these drives have to end up in points, doesn't it? The Bison have pretty much dominated the second half, except on the scoreboard.
And North Dakota State now over 300 yards of total offense, 155 on the ground. And here come the Bison. They'll shift and go empty. Five receivers.
Over 100 yards rushing in the third quarter.
Stick will throw across the middle. Tips and incomplete.
Well, Isbell was the one doing most of the celebrating after that play, so you have to assume it was number 90 that got a hand on it.
Hit him right in the face.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Boy, he's played a good game today.
Colby Isbell, just a junior. So a 42-yard field goal attempt coming up for Cam Peterson. He is 2 of 2 today. It's pretty much straight on the money. It is up, has plenty of leg, and it is no good. Wide right.
Well, as much as the Bears have been dominated in the second half, they are certainly in this football game.
And we'll take a timeout. 14:46 to go. North Dakota State still leads it by 10. Missouri State back on the field after a miss from Cam Peterson from 42 yards. He'll take over at the 25. Another quick drop by Lambert to Earl. Plank eventually brings him down after a gain of 4. This game brought into you in high definition by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs.
I was stumped closing on the play. Earl went in motion toward his quarterback and at the snap reverse pivoted, tried to get him out in some space.
Lambert on the comeback to Earl, complete all the way down to the 47-yard line, and that moves the chains.
I think at the point that Earl made his break, Allison slipped a little bit. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, real good timing. You see Allison trying to recover. Jalen, I think, slipped. So when his receiver stopped, he tried to stop and kept going a little bit.
The Bears really one play away from making this interesting.
Maybe it's just something about this place when NDSU plays down here. Remember the 3-0 game a few years ago?
Or the 21-17 victory. Nothing easy. Crowder steps out of a tackle and eventually forced out of bounds by Robbie Grimsley and Matt Plank after a pretty good gain inside NDSU territory to the 46.
Well, Crowder's finally injury free. He's battled some in his career here at Missouri State. We talked a little bit about in the first half his big play ability. If you weren't with us, he had a 64-yard touchdown last week on a run. So he's a big play type of a guy if you hand him the ball.
Missouri State continuing to go quick. Lambert flushed. Lost the football.
Fumble,
I think that
fumble,
thing is live.
Fumble.
It is picked up.
Steidel.
It's Aaron Steidel down to the 22-yard line. Wow. And I don't think Lambert was hit. He just lost the football.
Steidel made the play of the game defensively last week, forcing a fumble. Here he picks up the fumble. The pump fake, the ball flies out when he brings his arm back again. And then Steidel getting what he can get, and that is inside the 25.
And Missouri State was really in a rhythm there, and that is another critical mistake by Brody Lambert.
It was the first real signs of life for the offense for the Bears in the second half, and they just took it away from themselves. Lambert, now you just go sit down by yourself and there's nothing you can do about it. You know you blew that play.
His second fumble lost today. He's also thrown a pick.
Well, maybe this will be the time that
the
NDSU
previous play
gets
is under
in,
further review
to the end zone.
And this one's going to be reviewed. And again, because of
you
the
should.
Arm motion.
Well, you should. This is a huge play in the context of this game and the way it's played out early in the fourth. So you got to look at it
this
again.
Be immediate timeout.
Again, Lambert was the starter last year.
While they look, we're going to take a break.
And they'll take a quick timeout, and we will too. 13-3 as they take a look at this one on the replay. see Easton Stick bringing the offense out. They reviewed it, and it will stand as a fumble in a big play in the football game here in the fourth quarter. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. And
here's the pump fake, and then the ball flies out again. Tuska providing the pressure. He's had a real good day, Tuska has.
And there's room to the outside. That's going to be a touchdown for North Dakota State. King Frazier walks in. 22 yards for the touchdown.
Left side of the offensive line with tight end help. Smashes, just collapses that thing. And then Isbell runs past the play. We also saw one of the defensive backs, I think it was Matt Rush, that overran the play. And Frazier takes advantage of the easy touchdown today. There has not been things easy when it comes to points for NDSU, but that one was easy.
Peterson on to add the extra point, and that might do it. A lot of football game left, but the way Missouri State has struggled to score points today, we'll see. 13:08 to go. North Dakota State leads at 20-3 on the Ag Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. North Dakota State taking advantage of the Brody Lambert fumble, and King Frazier punching it in. One play, 22 yards. Take a look at the Bobcat game recap. Boy, that's a pretty good scoring drive. 6 seconds.
Well, you take a one-play touchdown drive every time. Last week we had a one-play touchdown drive. Remember Stick's long touchdown pass from 65 yards?
Cam Peterson on for another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed.
I doubt the Bison want to test Holloman. Nope, it's a poot or just fly it in the air.
Taken again by one of the up men. I think that's St. Peter again, and he gets what he can to the 32.
Now, people know all about Holloman's kick return ability, and he will be kicked away from a ton this year.
Brody Lambert, boy, again, a career game last week. He did not start the season as the quarterback here at Missouri State. That was Brent Ruddick, and kind of a bizarre situation.
Yep,
he's
yep.
been allegations of animal cruelty. He's been suspended from the team as they continue to look into that. So, again, Lambert has experience. He was a starter last year for the Bears.
Yeah, but also I was told that Lambert really handled that well, being beat out, coming out of camp, that type of thing.
Denson, and it's intercepted. Oh, I thought it was in the hands of Jalen Wimbush there for a second.
Oh, I don't think Wimbush could get his second hand on the ball. He had it on in one hand, it looked like. And if he holds on to that, there's another 6 points. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, zip to the flat, goes right through your receiver's hands. And Wimbush is obviously engaged with Furmanek, the tight end. If there's a little bit more space there, that's a pick.
Lambert, again, pressured. Has to throw it away. Nobody out there, but he's outside the pocket. So that will bring up third and long, and Tuska's been really active today, LT.
He's been tremendous coming off the edge, and he's a good speed guy. But if Lambert, well, I don't, you know, Missouri State can't really afford to run the ball, but if they don't at least hand it off a few times in the second half, third and long, they won't do it here. They're going to get the quarterback killed because the Bison are in go get them zone now.
Missouri State 5 of 12 on third down today.
Davis is in nickel situation. He's the nickel corner on the inside.
Lambert, boy, great catch. Furmanek stretched out, hauls it in at the 42, right at the first down Stick, and I think he's got enough.
Davis actually has fairly good position. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Furmanek makes a nice adjustment on the ball to the outside after it was already thrown. Real nice spot, picks up the first down. Exactly what you were supposed to do. Get to that first down marker and make a play.
Three catches, 24 yards for Furmanek. Junior from Belleville, Illinois. Hand off again to Randall. Runs into the pile, gets what he can, about a yard.
Again, not that I think it's going to be successful running the ball, but if you don't run it a few times against NDSU, you're just asking for trouble on your quarterback.
Let's take a look at our trivia question brought to you by the North Dakota Soybean Council and North Dakota Corn Council. Immature green soybean steamed in their pod served with salt are called what? Well, the answer coming up. Lambert again fires wide open receivers. LaMarcus Stewart, his first catch of the day. And the Memphis, Tennessee native has a first down inside Bison territory to the 42.
I think Earl got a piece of one of the Bison players running a little crossing route, and that helped open up the outside. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. There it is. Earl takes care of Grimsley, gets him off his man. Can he pick up the first down?
G. Tucker coming all the way back to make that tackle. And Lambert, quarterback draw, has some room to run, and Lambert has a first down to the 31-yard line.
Productive call, interesting call. I didn't see that one coming, did you? The quarterback run, you get your two big guys out in front. Lambert with another first down.
MJ Stump, Robbie Grimsley coming in to make that tackle, and Missouri State, after a costly mistake, now responding on this drive. Lambert, pretty good time here, and now he just throws out of bounds as time was running out. Stanley Jones, Nate Tangway got in there to put pressure on him.
Yeah, Tangway up the middle, Jones from the outside. Quarterback saving himself.
Lambert today, 18 of 29 for 134 yards and the interception.
Now the referee talking something over with one of the linesmen. And we'll go to the Bison sideline to explain what they saw to Coach Kleiman. I didn't pick up what they're looking at.
I didn't
talking
either.
About. You know, that last rush by Tangway, you know, he gets in there. He does so many things well for this NDSU defense, and he's so productive, and you hardly ever call his name because he's doing the dirty work inside. He has to engage, you know, a couple of blockers on most plays to try to free up teammates to make plays. That's a tough job, and he's good at it.
Obviously some great defensive interior tackles in the Missouri Valley. Certainly Carter Schultz, Northern Iowa comes to mind. Dalton Keene, we saw last week against Illinois State, pretty good.
Speaking of UNI, they're behind USD at halftime. That's
in Vermillion.
Yeah.
The Yokes, 21 points. Lambert flushed out, still on his feet, and then he's gang tackled. Nate Tangway got in to make that play after a short gain of two.
Well, we talked about Tangway, and here he gets his hands on a quarterback a little bit. See the double team on 99, then he plays off of that, gets back in a little bit on that, but a little pump to the outside, trying to hit the seam is what it looked like to me from up here is what Lambert was trying to do.
So third and eight coming up. Bison bringing pressure. Lambert airing it out, one-on-one coverage for Earl. It is incomplete. Jalen Allison in on the coverage and an excellent adjustment to the football, but just not quite enough space to haul that one in.
Well, probably the biggest roll of the dice today by Matt Entz, the defensive coordinator. He does get his hands on the ball, but first contact is out. He brought his safeties, and then you saw Menard drop back into the middle. So there was big-time blitz coming as Earl comes off the field limping, trying to make that touchdown catch. But, boy, the Bison dialed up the pressure. And when you do that, you're bringing your safeties, you know that there's a one-on-one on the outside with your corner.
Here's your trivia question answer to the North Dakota Soybean Council and North Dakota Corn Council trivia question. Immature green soybeans steamed in their pods, served with salt, are called what?
Edamame.
There you go.
Edamame.
You can tell we obviously eat a lot of those, you and I.
Review.
They're going to take a look at this because the feet were still on the ground a little bit when the ball arrived, but did they stay down long enough?
I thought after possession, first contact was on the white part, but it's a big play, and it's a potential scoring play, so you got to look at it.
All right, we'll take a quick timeout as they take a look at that. At this one, 10-17 to go, 20-3, North Dakota State leads on the A Country Farm Credit Service scoreboard. Back at Springfield, Missouri. Fourth down coming up here for Missouri State after they took a look at it and ruled incomplete on that attempt by Earl to haul it in. Well, it would have been a great catch and a 28-yard touchdown, but instead, the Bears backed up and they're going to attempt a field goal here. At least showing that they're going to attempt a field goal.
Be sure the safety is the holder, so a lot of times it's a backup quarterback, or you wonder if he'd roll out and fake it here, but you have a safety as your holder.
Drake hit from 50 earlier. This is from 35. And it was blocked.
Wimbush.
Yeah, Jalen Wimbush came in and was able to get a piece of it.
Off the edge, use your speed, anticipate the snap just right, and lay out for it. You'll see all of that here on the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Perfect replay, guys. That looks great. Left hand on it. Wimbush blocks it.
So that turns back Missouri State with just over 10 minutes to go, and now the Bison offense back on the field. We got a couple of barn burners going on in the Missouri Valley, and maybe a big surprise down in Vermilia. 28-17 now, the Yotes lead the Panthers at the end of the third quarter.
I'll agree there. I'll put that one in the big surprise category.
And Indiana State, Western Illinois, 14-13. That's a tight football game. Take a look at Dave Steckel and his bunch. This would be their first Missouri Valley Conference loss. And this game brought to you in high definition by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs. Back to the ground game. Boy, great pursuit again by Cole as he caught Lance Dunn for a loss of one.
Take any game film of Missouri State over the last couple of years, pop it in, and when they're playing defense, you'll see him all over the place. Cole is, as Coach Kleiman said, one of the premier defensive players in our conference.
Yeah, Cole, interesting guy, was a third-team All-State running back, 4,100 rushing yards in high school, 61 ground touchdowns. And this past spring, after spring ball in, spent a few weeks in the Dominican on a mission trip. Pretty well-rounded young man.
Tackle for loss for Cole on that play.
Back to power this time, and done a little more room to run. Able to pick up seven. We'll bring up third and four, third and five. Cameron Price coming up to make the tackle.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Good kick out block there by Johnson. And then Dunn gets what he can.
NDSU content to milk the clock as much as possible here.
You know, if the Bears don't get off the field now, they're not getting the ball back with much time left. If NDSU can get this third down, it just has a feel like it'll be a grinder.
Stick is going to throw, or he might run. Comeback route. Tiptoed on the sidelines. Was he in bounds?
Yeah,
I think he was, and that's Erzendowski making the catch.
Yep, he was in. Had his feet set. Ball arrives. Make the catch. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Tiptoes. If he puts his heels down, he's probably out of bounds, but he stays up on the ball of his feet, and it's a catch.
Fourth reception of the day for R.J. Erzendowski. He's got 73 yards receiving. Big third down for North Dakota State as the clock continues to wind down towards 8 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. King Frazier's got some linemen in front of him, and another first down for Frazier.
A little bit of the coordinator versus coordinator guessing game, because the defensive line stunt took one of the linemen, Colburn, and brought him to the near side while the Bison had the play call to the right. A few less tacklers in that area.
I didn't see a flag, but they whistled the...
No, that's what Coach Kleiman is saying. How come the clock is not winding?
Officials came in waving their arms to stop the clock, and was looking for a flag. I did not see one.
Maybe we'll get an explanation or not. Well, coaches will. I don't think we will.
I thought Frazier was across the 50. The football has been brought back inside NDSU territory to the 49. Well, both coaches are getting an explanation, so that's encouraging, but we don't know.
I didn't see it. I'm not that you at home can watch this, but I'm shrugging my shoulders because I don't know. But now the ball has moved up to the 50. Maybe it's just trying to figure out where the ball should be spotted.
I asked Coach Steckel this week about, you know, what did you do right away after the last season? I mean, your teeth get kicked in, 1-10. It was tough on the guys. I said, you know, our demeanor didn't change. We just went about our business and told the guys, continue to believe, get in the weight room, let's get stronger, let's get faster. And that's evident. They are much faster. Even Tim Polisek said on defense, they're a step faster at pretty much every position.
Well, we've seen today the improvement that Missouri State made. I mean, Missouri State gave up over 600 yards to the Bison last year. You know, and Coach, you know, Steckel said, hey, it's simple things. It's fundamentals. It's players starting to understand their roles.
Oh, the seas just part again for Frazier, and he pulls ahead for a first down and a gain of close to 12.
Well, when the Bison do that, I know this is a short yardage situation you're selling out, but when the Bison are getting holes that big, then you know that as a defense, you've probably been had.
Boy, pretty good seal block there by Colin Connor on Dylan Cole, and that really sprung that thing. Frazier now over 100 yards rushing on the day, 110 and a touchdown. Frazier again, flag comes in, Cole makes the tackle.
Thought they threw it in the direction of where Zach Johnson was, but we'll see.
Personal foul, chop block. Offense number 75 and 66. 15-yard penalty, replay, first down.
And you were right, LT, that's where Coonard and Zach Johnson were. Maybe a high-low there. There's a look at Big Zach.
Yeah, we do have a Big Zach, Little Zach, even though Little Zach is bigger than Big Zach, isn't he?
He's taller.
Taller. And we have a old Tuska and a young Tuska.
Then you got the cousins, Dom Davis and Pierre G. Tucker.
At least they don't have the same last name.
So that puts NDSU all the way back inside their own territory, first and 25. Lance Dunn, room to roam, across the 50 to the 40, and down to about the 37-yard line.
Well, it's taken a while, but that Bison offense is winning its battles right now. Check out Johnson, gets inside, and then, what was that? I think that was Ilias again with a nice seal. Pulls out front, pins that defensive man in, and you pick up 14 yards on the carry. Good look there at Landon Leckler, right tackle, doing some work.
Frazier to the outside, bounces back inside and has a first down to the 26-yard line.
You go back to the opening drive of this second half, you know, Brian, and even though we sit there and go, well, the Bison left points out there, but what they did in that drive is establish a physical presence, which is now turned into a physical dominance here in the second half. So, yeah, it was a nice long drive, did not score, but it set the tone. Bison came out of the locker room, and they started beating on some guys, and now it's going to end up with another road victory.
Frazier now up to 122 yards on the ground, and the Bison at 230 total. More room. And how about the speed this time for Bruce Anderson inside the 10, pushed out of bounds at about the 3.
Ooh, Cole getting up real slow after preventing Anderson from getting into the end zone. Well, it's designed to be a power play, A-gap power, but the outside opens up. Anderson makes the right cut about 2 yards past the line of scrimmage. And the Bison are out at the 4. A lot of hands on hips from those defensive linemen right now. They were living the high life in the first half, and in the second half, they've been dominated. Power again.
Frazier steps out of one tackle, runs around Dylan Cole, touchdown.
Well, that's the exclamation point that I think this Bison offense really wanted. They wanted to be rewarded with a long drive touchdown. Remember, you go back with about eight minutes left on that third down, and we said if the Bison get this first down, which it was the pass to Erzendowski, well, Missouri State's going to be in trouble. And there's another 6 points on the board and another almost 4 minutes off the clock.
Extra point is up, and it is good. And North Dakota State has salted this one away, and they have done it on the ground. Just punishing Missouri State up front. 256 rushing yards total here today.
That's over 200 in the second half.
Back to wrap things up. 5 minutes to go from here in Springfield. The big boys up front getting it done here in the second half. There's a look at Austin Cooner, Jack Plankers, Tanner Volson, Colin Connor, Zach Johnson. Those guys have had themselves pretty good final 30 minutes. Holloman on the return.
Yeah, and with the lead, you can afford to kick it deep. You can afford to let Holloman, you know, get a chance. Now you gained about 15 yards from other than kicking it short.
Take a look at our Bobcat game recap. 9 plays, 72 yards, 517, as King Frazier ran over a couple of guys into the end zone for a touchdown.
All on the ground except that critical early third down pickup pass to Erzendowski.
Now, the amazing thing about that was the chop block. It was first and 25, and in two runs. NDSU made it up. Inside handoff, Randall dives ahead, picks up 6.
Bison will play quite a bit, I think, of just base 2-deep coverage right here. No reason to gamble, no reason to bring your safeties into that box until you know you've read run. Got Tucker playing the nickel position on the Y side, the top of your screen.
Quarterback power game. Wimbush comes in to make the tackle on Lambert after a gain of 2.
Well, Lambert's just doing some counting. He's just going, okay, what do we see numbers-wise? Who's in the box? Yeah, let's try to run this.
We got a new quarterback in there, LT. Michael Briggs is in at quarterback. Oh, okay. He's the one that ran the football there. And Briggs, redshirt freshman,
has not completed a pass yet this year in 6 attempts.
From Lee Summit, Missouri. Yeah, he's thrown a pick.
I guess he's completed one then, is that what you're saying? Just to the wrong off fumble. He covered it back up. Yeah, at least somebody has caught one of his passes. That's what you're saying, right?
Correct. That brings up fourth down, and I think Missouri State content to punt the football away, try to regroup and get ready for next week.
But on the defensive side, you know, Missouri State's going to look at the first, especially the first half, and see a lot of things that it likes and continues to try and build off of it.
Missouri State back home next Saturday against Western Illinois and homecoming here in Springfield. They'll try to regroup, and the Leathernecks in tight contest. Oh, boy. Fumble on the return, and that is not going to make Chris Kleiman happy as Erzendowski muffs it. And recovered on the play by Eric Greeley, a linebacker.
Well, remember why he's out there. That's because the sure-handed guy, Eric Perkins, who's returned punts for a long, long time, well, he's dealing with an injury. So Shepard's been back there, and he let a couple bounce on the ground, and now Erzendowski's been back there, and he didn't misjudge that one as it flew over his shoulder.
And here is our high-def sponsor, Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs. Beautiful day. Great day to televise a football game here in Springfield.
We've had beautiful pitchers coming out of this place today, too, in high def.
So Lambert back in the game. And he airmails this throw, looking for Willis Chambers. Jalen Allison on the coverage.
Yeah, throwing a deep post.
Should mention with Eric Perkins, too. I had a chance to chat with him this week. And obviously disappointed, a broken thumb. Was contemplating after getting it looked at and figured out if he can just cast it up and still contribute on special teams, because he recognizes, you know, that's where there's a need right now for North Dakota State. A little thin in that area.
And that's where Perkins has made his mark with this team, too.
Lambert, boy, had an open receiver that time, and that pass pretty much right on the money. But again, Chambers can't hang on, and a flag comes in.
The flag is away from where the ball was. There were two Missouri State and North Dakota State players kind of hooked up right around the 25-yard line on the near side. And one of the Missouri State players was on the turf. And I'm assuming that's why the flag was thrown.
Holding, defense, number 23, 10-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
Well, I actually think they got the wrong Jalen on that. 23 was playing defense on the ball side. The flag was on the near side where Allison was.
So a first down for Missouri State. And Lambert's going to run it. Working off a couple of blocks. Taken down after a gain of five. Craig Menard got in there, among others.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Get the two guards out in front.
Blake Williams has played some extended reps today for North Dakota State.
I'm a little surprised that in this end, Lambert's elected to run the ball as much as he has, taking a few more shots.
That pass complete to LaMarcus Stewart, his second catch of the day inside the 20. And this copyrighted broadcast is property of North Dakota State University. Any rebroadcast, reproduction, or distribution without the consent of NDSU is strictly prohibited. Under two to go. Lambert again is going to run it. Boy, he's got room in front inside the 10 and down inside the 5-yard line.
They got a hold.
And a flag did come in there back at the 20.
A hold or a chop block? I think it's going to be a chop block.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
I think they're getting 77 with a chop block.
Personal foul, chop block. Number 68 and 77, 15-yard penalty, third down.
Yeah, it was. I think it was the two guys engaged to get with Williams on the inside. They let Menard come free off the edge, and then those two guys ganged up on the defensive tackle.
Jordan Turner whistled for that one, and that costs the Bears a first and goal at the 5. Six penalties, 52 yards on the Bears today. North Dakota State, 8 penalties for 70 yards. Lambert fires across the middle, caught right on the money that time. Catch made by Holloman to the 26. Dom Davis got in there to make the tackle.
Lambert gets this ball off in good time. Bison again playing deep coverage, given the underneath. That was third and 17 after all.
So fourth and 9. Minute to go. Lambert trying to buy time. Fires, and this one is intercepted. And that will put a cap on it as Robbie Grimsley comes up with it.
Number 5, garden number 5. And Grimsley steps in front of Holloman and does a real nice job of picking this one right off the top of the turf. Improvised mode by Lambert. Grimsley steps in front and gets his pick.
Good look out on the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Good hands by the former Minnesota Mr. Football from Hutchinson, Minnesota.
We haven't, nah, the Jacks, that's a late game, right?
It is.
Yeah, so that's who NDSU will worry about next week. And they are, the Jackrabbits are in Carbondale, if I'm right on that.
A couple of plays here, and North Dakota State will salt it away, and that will do it. An opportunity here for Ty Brooks. First career carry for the former Fargo South Bruin. Look how slippery he is. Picks up 11.
But he's got to love his average right now. He's averaging 11 yards a carry. Of course, we saw Ty and getting a chance on a special teams earlier when he had a kickoff return.
And NDSU will have to take another snap, as Cole Davis is also in the game at quarterback, and we're seeing a few other backups. Kayvon Hawkins in at wide receiver, among others. Oof. Alex Jones put a pretty good wallop on Brooks that time and brought him down, and that will be the final football play of the game. And North Dakota State will improve to 2-0 in the Valley, 5-0 overall, with a 27-3 victory over the Missouri State Bears.
Physically better in the second half, as NDSU often is. It was won, I think, by the offensive line in the second half.
269 yards on the ground for North Dakota State.
And the Bison had 52 yards rushing at halftime.
And we've seen that script before, LT.
It is something that has played out a lot in the last 6 years.
We will take a timeout.
Bison ended up scoring all the points in the second half at 27-3 is our final score.
NDSU will take a knee at the 50-yard line, and we'll take a quick timeout and be back with more to wrap things up from here in Springfield after this. Back in Springfield, Missouri, and wouldn't you know it, a Missouri native is our Nodak Mutual
fitting.
Insurance player of the game, and that's King Frazier, who ran really hard today. 19 carries, 126 yards, and 2 touchdowns.
I think the big thing, too, is that King had 128 total, so that means he only went backwards for 2 yards in this game, and those 2 touchdowns along a 22. He averaged 6.6 yards a carry, especially in that second half when his offensive line helped open holes, but he did that as well. He finished runs, and Frazier continues to do that this year. Impressive yards after contact again today. Here's one of those 2 touchdowns.
Really, since the Eastern Washington game, I think King has really been a different runner. Started against Iowa, he rushed for nearly 100 yards there. Was good again last week, and then today, really in the second half, behind that offensive line, they just continued to bruise the boys up front for the Bears. We'll take another quick timeout and wrap things up from here in Springfield. 27-3, your final on the Ag Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. North Dakota State still unbeaten on the season. 5-0 overall, 27-3 victors over Missouri State today, as we take a look at your stats report brought to you by the North Dakota Certified Seed Producers.
Well, 217 of the 269 yards rushing happened in the second half for North Dakota State. Just establishing a physical dominance, taking over time of possession, some long drives, even though early in the second half some of those drives didn't produce points. But hey, when you're over 400 yards of total offense, once again, you're rushing for 269 and your defense is only allowing 30 yards rushing to a team that wants to try to establish the run, you're dominating the line of scrimmage. That's how you win football games.
Boy, the last three opponents for North Dakota State have rushed for 34 yards, 30 yards, and 30 yards. Not going to have a lot of success if you're not able to run the football against North Dakota State. And I think that was evident today. Let's stat report brought to you by the North Dakota Certified Seed Producers. LT, I know South Dakota State's always a big game.
Fun one.
The Jacks coming in, they're really, I think, irritated with this losing streak to North Dakota State that has extended over 6 years. And hopefully coming into Fargo can take care of business.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how the Jacks do tonight on the road. Their offense has been tremendous. Christian triggering things offensively. South Dakota State's defense has not been good, and the Bison have usually found a way to take teams who are not playing very good defense and beating them.
You take the win, obviously, but Tim Polasek, I think, offensively saying, hey, we've missed a few opportunities. And those are things that are at least correctable you can clean up before your rivals come in next weekend.
Oh, yeah. The Bison will want – they ended up with 27 points. In their mind, it probably should have been in the upper 40s.
Well, that will do it as the fans that are here in the green and gold celebrate another Bison victory. And pretty special moment, I'm sure, for the two Missouri natives, King Frazier and also Darius Shepherd, playing a pretty good game today as well. That will do it. Thanks so much for tuning in all across the KBOI, KFYR Bison Network. For Beth Houle and Lee Timmerman, I'm Brian Shawn. Our entire crew here in Springfield says so long, and we'll see ya next Saturday when the Jackrabbits come to town. Have a great Saturday, everybody.